Rajesh from the classrooms. Welcome to a very interesting and fascinating English grammar lesson about conditionals. If you are learning English, you will definitely find this lesson helpful. As conditionals are very common, we use them all the time. Learning to know how to use conditional is going to help us to express more clearly and effectively. In grammar, you know, there are rules, there are exceptions, sometimes they apply, sometimes they don't apply. We use conditional sentences to express what actually happens, what could happen, what we wish would happen, what might happen. I repeat, we use conditional sentences to express what actually happens, what could happen, what we wish would happen, what might happen. Now look at the following examples. They are all are really similar, but they are not the same. If I heat water, it boils. If I heat water, it will boil. If I heated water, it would boil. If I had heated water, it would have boiled. I repeat. If I heat water, it boils. If I heat water, it will boil. If I heated water, it would boil. If I had heated water, it would have boiled. So what is common in these examples? There are two parts, there are two clauses separated by a comma, and they all use the conjunction if. If clause is the condition or event that must happen for the other thing to happen. Conditional clause is the condition or event that must happen in order to the other thing to happen. That is why it is called the if clause. To get it better, take another example. We cannot get this without squeezing this. We cannot get a mango juice without squeezing a mango. The result can only happen if the if clause happens. The result can only happen if the if clause happens. In all conditional sentences, we have two clauses, the if clause and the result clause, as you see in these examples. In all conditional sentences, there are two clauses, the condition clause and the result clause. Result clause cannot happen without the condition clause. Check out the verbs. This is where the main difference lies. You can check out the verbs here. This is where the main difference between these conditions lies. And the meaning is different too. You can see it. You can find the difference here. If I heat water, it boils. If I heat water, it will boil. If I heated water, it would boil. If I had heated water, it would have boiled. If you haven't already noticed, there are four types of conditionals. Zero conditional, first one. First conditional, second conditional, and third conditional. I am today dealing with the first two type of conditionals, that is the zero conditional and the first conditional. We have prepared a very interesting content for you. The only thing you will have to do is to like and subscribe this channel. I recommend you to take a screenshot of these examples for your study purpose. So let's get into this lesson. We have the zero conditional. What is the structure in the zero conditional? We have the present simple in the first part, that is in the conditional clause, and the present simple in the second part, that is in the result clause. Take an example. If we heat butter, it melts. There is present simple in the first part, that is in the conditional clause, and we have the same tense, that is present simple in the result clause. We used to talk about habits, facts and truths in this zero condition. We cannot argue about it. Take some more examples. If we leave the food outside the fridge, it spoils. If the sun rises in the east, it sets in the west. If we boil water, if we heat water, it boils. There are many examples. Then we have the first conditional in which we discuss about possible and likely future events. It is also called possible conditional. There is possibility. Something might happen, something might not happen. Look at the formula, look at the grammar structure of the sentence. We use if plus present simple in the first part, that is in the conditional clause, and we use will plus first form of verb, that is verb infinitive, in the second part, that is in the result clause. Take an example. If I get sick, I will go to the doctor. It is quite possible that I may get sick, and if it happens, then there is probability that I will go to the doctor. This is all about the first conditional. Today we have discussed about zero conditional, first conditional. Next two types will be discussed in the next video. If you want more examples to practice, you can go through any grammar book at your home. Please like and subscribe this channel. We have prepared very hard content for you. The only thing you will have to do is to like and subscribe this channel. This will really help us. We will see you in the next video. Till then, have a nice time.